The boyfriends of 50-year-old Sheila LaBarre of Epping, New Hampshire have one thing in common. They are dead.
It's the real true life story of a sadistic devil temptress from small town New Hampshire.
And LaBarre wouldn't admit to killing County and then Michael DeLage. Sheila LaBarre case was, I think, the scariest and most evil. Sheila LaBarre is accused of killing men, dismembering their bodies, and incinerating the remains, spreading them on her 115-acre horse farm in an isolated part of New Hampshire. Sheila LaBarre was a seductress who lived on this secluded farm in New Hampshire. Dr. LaBarre had put out a Lonely Hearts ad in a magazine that Sheila responded to. Dr. LaBarre was a nice guy, elderly chiropractor, well-respected in the community, and he owned this huge farm in Epping, New Hampshire, 115 acres. She came to New Hampshire from Alabama, where she had a very tumultuous past. She had a difficult relationship with men. All the neighbors were afraid of Sheila. That was one of the ways she was able to do what she was able to do. People didn't want to bother with her. She was like a wasp. You didn't want to get stung by her. Sheila's farmhouse was filled with her children, rabbits, hundreds of free-range rabbits that would just roam around, and she took care of them as if they really were her children. The first time you approach the farm and you're passing all these trees, it feels like you're going into a dark cave. It feels like you're going to someplace very disturbing, very scary. Kenneth County was a young man whom Sheila met through a telephone dating service. He was young, but he was slow, he was easily led, and within a few days of meeting Sheila, he moved to this farm, but he was never seen again. When the police finally came to the farm to look for Kenneth County, they found nobody home at the time, but they did see two active fires burning in a fire pit. And when they examined the fire pit closely, they were able to find a human bone sticking out of the fire. Other men who had visited the farm, but nobody knows what happened to him. Is she crazy? That's what everyone always asks me.
You got to know her a little bit. I mean, what was she crazy?
But she's got to be insane.
I think I'd leave it for the reader to decide that question for themselves.